Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us and make us from those who are accepted in this month of Ramadan, for having fasted for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for having stood up in the night for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for having recited the Al-Quran for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for having the concern to rectify our soul and upgrade our iman for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase it for us. Amin. Alhamdulillah, we are now in the second half of the month of Ramadan, and we have to examine our amal. We have to check our action, how far we have gone and how much benefit have we taken of this beautiful month of Ramadan. And we have to check our heart as well, how much the disease of the heart have we cured from our hearts, and how much love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have increased in our hearts. If we find them all to be still, or in other words, to still be in the same condition or position as pre-Ramadan, we should try to ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make a strong intention and strive in the second half of this month to get the maximum benefit of the month of Ramadan. And if we find there is some change in our life, or our ibadat is becoming better, and we focus more on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that our hearts now feel contented and feel that it is cured from the disease, and the love and the recognition of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has start coming into our hearts, then we have to keep on continuing our effort to increase it and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give the ability to keep it until we die. Alhamdulillah, now we are on the night of 17th of Ramadan. In this night, there are two great things was happened in our history, our Islamic history. The first one, the revelation of the Quran, where some ulama differ and said that the nuzul of Quran was took place on 24th of Ramadan, and majority said was happened on 17th of Ramadan. And inshallah, tomorrow I think one of the well-known scholars in Malaysia will elaborate in this in detail. And the second one, that thing happened in the 17th of Ramadan, the great battle of Badr, the great battle of Badr, the first battle in Islam, when it was the first time ever that the Muslims confronted the kuffar in defending Islam, in which everyone is well aware that in this battle the Muslim army is only about 313 and face the kuffar about thousands well equipped mushrikeen. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant victory to the Muslim. Inshallah, we can elaborate the battle of Badr in some other time. For today, I would like to focus on our discussion, that is what the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how to get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the connection between Quran and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Quran being the means of guidance to the people. So now, we spoke a few days ago that how to attain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remove the love of dunya. And now, what are the connection between Quran and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Quran is a means of a guidance to the people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنُ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. In the month of Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, the Quran was revealed as a mean of guidance to the people and clear proof for the guidance and the criterions to differentiate between right and wrong. So if you want to know what is right, what is wrong, so we have to go and check in Quran. So the ulama said, how great was Quran? How great is the Quran? Because the Quran was revealed in the month of Ramadan. Syahrul Ramadan, alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. The month of Ramadan, Syahrul Ramadan. Allah praise the month of Ramadan. Why Allah SWT praise the month of Ramadan? Because alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. Because in this month Allah Subhanahu wa Taala reveal the Quran, and the Quran was revealed in this month, and not just the month, not just the month, and the day that the Quran was revealed become great as well. Like Allah Subhanahu wa Taala mention in the Suratul Qadar, Inna anzalnahu fi lailatul qadar. Indeed, we have revealed the Quran in the night of Qadar. So we said the ulama of Mufassir, the ulama of Tafsir said, this ayat Inna anzalnahu fi lailatul qadar mean the Quran was revealed from the Lahul Mahfuz to the Baitul Ma'mur in the night of Qadar, Lailatul Qadar. Such a very great, Allah Subhanahu wa Taala choose one very great day to reveal the Quran from Lahul Mahfuz to the Baitul Ma'mur. From the Baitul Ma'mur revealed to Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the first revelation was take place in the great great month. This is the month of Ramadan. Such a powerful and such a powerful night and blessed night. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala made it such a night that become so blessed and powerful because of the revelation of the Quran in that night. Just think for a moment how great the Quran is. First, because the man where the Quran was revealed is become great. Allah multiplied the reward. Allah opened all the doors of forgiveness. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala opens all the door of maghfirah, and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala release how many people from Jahannam just because of the man. This man was revealed the Quran. And the second one, the day where the Quran was revealed become great, that is Lailatul Qadar. Alladhi khairu min ahri min alfi shahr. That day is, one day is equivalent to 1000 months. It's such a very great day. So that to show the greatness of the Quran. And the third one, the person who received the Quran, not a normal person, who was received the Quran is the most asraful makhlukat, is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the one who carry the Quran from Baitul Ma'mur, who the one who be entrust from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala to deliver the Quran to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is only the best angels, that is Jibril alaihi wasallam. So if you have to realize the Quran, the quality of Quran, the greatness of the Quran, Allahu Akbar, such a great thing, such a great things that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala reveal to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the bless and the place that the Quran was revealed, such a very great place, where in Makkah Mukarramah. So to think just for a moment how great the Quran is. Now the question is, who did Allah Subhanahu wa Taala reveal the Quran? To whom Allah Subhanahu wa Taala reveal the Quran? Is it Allah Subhanahu wa Taala reveal to the mountain? Of course, definitely will answer no. Because Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said in Quran, "Law anzalna hadzal Qur'ana 'ala jabalin la ra'aitahu khashi'an mutasaddian min khashyatillah." Indeed, law, if we have sent reveal this Quran on the mountain, definitely la ra'aitahu, you will surely see that the mountain humbling and will surrender an account of fear to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. So much weight that Allah Subhanahu the Quran is, the mountain cannot take it. Allah Subhanahu wa Taala send, if Allah Subhanahu wa Taala send into the mountain, mountain cannot take it. If Allah Subhanahu wa Taala send it to other creation of Allah, they also cannot take the bear of the heaviness of the Quran. So it's a very great word of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Definitely Allah Subhanahu wa Taala send the Quran for the guidance of mankind. This is Quran has revealed for the purpose of guidance for the mankind. Like the previous ayat that I read, Syahr Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran hudan linnas. Quran was revealed for the purpose. What purpose? Guide, to guide the mankind. To guide the mankind. We, when we come here, we don't know anything. We can't see. We don't know who is Allah. We cannot recognize Allah. So Allah give us such a very powerful, great word, great kalam of Allah, great book, mu'jizat, that can tell us who is the true Rob? Who is the true sustainer? Who is the true creator? From Quran, we can see the recognize of Allah SWT. We can get the love of Allah SWT. We can recognize the powerful of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Allah SWT said in many ayat, whenever Allah SWT mention the ayat concerning, regarding the greatness of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, at the end of the ayat, Allah SWT will end with afala tatkilun, afala tatafakkarun. Why you don't think? Why you don't ponder? Just ponder a moment. You see, mountain, such a great creation, moon, suns, who create this thing? It just come like that, like beam, back bang, what the theory of the atheists. They say no, the world just come, just suddenly come, bam. It cannot, it's impossible, it's impossible. It must be someone who create this all, such a very organized world. So Quran will tell us, when we see the Quran, when we read the Quran, when we understand the Quran, then we know, we will recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will see the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we get the Quran, and when we receive the Quran, when we understand the Quran, a person that understand the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will make that great. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will make them great, like the sahaba radiallahu ajma'in. They are like normal people. When before the revelation of the Quran, sahaba radiallahu ajma'in was in the state of jahiliyah, the worst man ever in the history of mankind. They just kill for nothing, for no reason. They kill one another. They gamble for the baby in the stomach of the woman. They gamble, which one, which baby, boy or girl? Girl, you boy, okay, now we cut the stomach. Such a ignorant, pre-Islamic time, so jahiliyah. But when the revelation come, when the Quran come to the people of Arab, the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught the sahaba radhiyallahu ajma'in, and they receive the Quran, they become such a great human being. And there is no history ever that man can beat the era of sahaba radhiyallahu ajma'in. No one in the history can beat the history of sahaba radhiyallahu ajma'in. And the mashayikh explain, some ulama explain that the amount of love you have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be seen how much you love Quran. Sahaba radhiyallahu an, they used to love Quran, such a very great love to Quran, that is indicate to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the ulama said, the amount of love you have for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be seen by how much you love the Quran. If you have great love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you have great love for the Quran. If you have love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will definitely, you have love in this Quran. If you have great love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then this Quran will become your friend. The most sahaba embrace Islam. Most of sahaba embrace Islam because of the guidance of the Quran. Their heart melt when they heard the ayat of Quran, Al-Karim, being recited in front of them. Like the famous story of Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu an. Such a brave and harsh person, whom originally intended to kill Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He intend to kill Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's on his way to kill Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he met Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas in one narration. And Sa'd said, "Where are you going, Umar?" "I want to kill Muhammad." He said, you think the Banu Hashim and Banu Mudar will leave you just like that? And then Umar radiallahu said, "I heard you also become Muslim." So Umar radiallahu drawn his sword, and Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas drawn his sword. And he said, "Umar, before you fight with me, go to your own house. Your sister Fatima bin Umar bin Khattab has embraced Islam." Umar radiallahu turned his direction and go to his sister house. And while he's walking toward his sister house, and his sister, or the household where his sister was there, and his husband, her husband, his name was Sa'id ibn Zaid. And then the teacher, Khabbab bin Arad, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to appoint one sahaba to teach the new Muslim. So when they heard Umar radhiyallahu anhu come, Khabbab radhiyallahu anhu ran away. Khabbab radhiyallahu anhu ran away to just to hide from Umar radhiyallahu anhu, because he know when Umar come will beat everyone. So Umar radhiyallahu anhu come and then say, "Ask his sister, are you embrace Islam? You leave your forefather, your religion of your forefathers." And said, "Why, Umar? What do you think about if this religion is better than before, previous religion?" And then he start kicking and hitting his brother-in-law. Eventually, his sister tell Umar, "Leave us alone. You can do whatever you want. We will never ever leave this religion." And that word strike Umar's heart. And then Umar radhiyallahu anhu said, "What you were reading?" And his sister said, "This Quran. I want to recite." So, "No, you are najis. You are najis. You cannot recite this Quran. Go take bath." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already give some nur to the heart of Umar radhiyallahu anhu, and he take bath and come. When he want to recite, Khabbab bin Arad come out from the place where he hide. And then Khabbab radhiyallahu anhu sit and teach and read in front of Umar radhiyallahu an. Hafiz Ibrahim Al-Misri, I want to quote the poetry, very very nice poetry. Hafiz Ibrahim Al-Misri has written a beautiful poetry regarding the conversion of Umar radhiyallahu an. And he said, qad kunta a'da a'adiha fasirta laha bi ni'matillah hisnan min a'adiha. You were the worst enemy of Islam, Umar. You were the worst enemy of Islam, but by the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you became that fortress to defend Islam against its enemy. Kharajta tabghi adha fi Muhammadiha walil hanifati jabbarun man yuwalliha. You wanted to hurt Islam by hurting Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has a sound, very great protector. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself protect his deen. Let us see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect his deen. The one who come to murder Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who come to kill Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who come to oppress the Muslim, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change him. Falam takat tasma'ul ayatil baligha hattan kafa'ta tinawi man yunawiha. Barely did this verse of the Quran strike your ear and penetrate into your heart, except that at the very moment you were the opponent of Islam, become the opponent of Islam's enemy. The Khabab radiallahu an teach Umar radiallahu an. He was sitting and in Khabab the Qari, Khabab was recite in front of Umar what he was reading. He was reading Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Taha ma anzalna alaykal Qur'an litashqa illa tadhkaratan liman yakhsha tanzilan mimman khalaqal arda was samawati al-ula ar-rahman ar-rahmanu alal arshi istawa ila qawlihi innani anallah la ilaha illa ana fa'budni wa aqimis salata li dhikri. The Umar radhiyallahu anhu said, ma yanbaghi an liman yaqulu hadzal kalami an ya'budu ma siwahu dulluni ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Umar radhiyallahu anhu said, the one who said, I am Allah, there is no God beside me, does worship me and worship none beside me, no one should be worship other than him, bring me, show me the Muhammad, where is Muhammad? And then the poetry continue. Sami'ta surat at-taha min murattiliha fazulzilat niyatun qad kunta tanwiha. You listen the Quran being read by its qari, Khabbab was recite the Quran. Thus the intention of Umar is to kill. The intention in your heart was shaken and turned upside down, and you come with the intention to kill, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change the intention, become iman. Wa qulta fiha maqalan la yutawiluhu qawlul muhibbi alladhi qad bata yatriha. In praising of the Quran, you say such word that if a lover had to spend the whole night praising his beloved, it could not compare to the praise that you showered on the Quran in that moment. This is Umar. Whenever he went, he heard Taha, Surah Taha, from Surah Taha until innani anallah la ilaha illa ana fa'budni wa aqimus salah, his heart has shake and his niat become turn. Then when he said dulluni ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, show me where is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so they took Hazrat Umar radhiyallahu an to the house where Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. At the time the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the house of Arqam ibn Abi Arqam. Hamzah radhiyallahu an was standing at the door. Hamzah radhiyallahu an become Muslim 3 days before Umar radhiyallahu an. So he was guarding the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then he saw Hamzah radhiyallahu an saw Umar come, and then he said, "Oh Umar, what do you want? Umar, what do you want?" Hamzah stopped him. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked from inside, "Who is that door?" And Hamzah said, "Umar." And then Hamzah tell Umar, "Umar, go away from here. Don't disturb us." Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Let him enter. Udkhuluhu. Let him enter." Hazrat Umar radhiyallahu anhu come inside, and all that rage has gone from his heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has replaced it with something else. He said, "Umar." Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Umar, come close, close, close." Umar radhiyallahu anhu stand in front of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and went down on his knees. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam grabbed him and said, "Oh Umar, how long will you continue with your kufur? Are you waiting for the same thing that happened to Walid ibn Mughirah to happen to you? How long, O Umar? How long will you continue? Umar radiallahu an had no reply but to say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. The entire house, when the moment Umar radiallahu an said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah, the entire house of Arqam ibn Arqam make takbir, and the road of Makkah, all the Muslims start making takbir. And then the poetry continue, wa yawma aslamta azzal haqqi wartafa'at an kahiluddin athqalan yu'aniha. And the day when you, Umar, become a Muslim, Islam went up. Islam went up, regained its honor, and all those difficulty that was resting on Islam's shoulder were taken away by a blink of a moment. Just Islam of Umar, he take all the burden of the Muslim. So this is what? Through the guidance of the Quran. Through the Quran, just recite the Quran in front of Umar, Umar radhiyallahu hajj become melt and he from hurting, from intent to hurting, killing Nabi SAW, now he become embraced and become enemy of the Islam now. Become the fortress of the Islam. And Umar radhiyallahu anhu become such a great man, such a great man, such a great Muslim leaders. And even superpower of those time, even the Roman and Persian will tremble hearing his name. How did he become such a great? How Umar radhiyallahu become such a great sahaba? Because of the guidance of the Quran. Because of the Quran. So my respected brothers and sisters, so we have to ask ourselves, how much we spend our time to look at this great gift of Al-Quran? How much we have spent our time to look at this great gift of Al-Quran? How much concern do we have for our recitation of Al-Quran? How much we practice the Quran in our life? How much effort we do we make to learn the meaning of Al-Quran? And how much we take the Al-Quran for our guidance? So when Imam read Allahu Akbar, if you understand the meaning of Quran, you also will crying. Such a very azab. But because we are neglect on the meaning of the Quran, whenever ayat azab will come coming past to us, our heart still thinking about dunya. How dare is that? The moment Imam recite the azab concerning azab jahannam, ya ayyuhal ladzi, ya ayyuhan nas, what the ayat, I can't remember. The Allah SWT say the shaking of the world. The shaking of the world because of the day of Qiyamah. The shaking of the world. So this how Allah SWT describing the day of Qiyamah. If you understood, our heart will shake. Our heart will shake. But because of we don't recognize who give this Quran, who send this Quran, we don't understand the greatness of this Quran, we still thinking about this dunya. We think about our family. We think about our home and car and house and so on. Why we not thinking about the greatness of Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala? So my respected brothers and sisters, so from tonight, we have to make intention, true intention, that we have to change our life. Our life should accordance to the life of the Quran, like the Sahaba radiallahu an. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor you how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor the Sahaba radiallahu ajmain. There's a lot of story. I have, actually there's two, three story, but the time is too short. How the Fudail ibn Iyad, also one of the story, Fudail ibn Iyad, he was a highway robbery. He's a Muslim, but he was a highway robbery. And just he intend to rob another house. He said, this house I never rob. I never come. So I want to go to this house. So when he jumped to this house, I just making short this story. This Fudail ibn Iyad, he jumped into the house and the owner was recite the Quran. What ayat he recite? Alam ya'ninil ladhina amanu an takhsha'a qulubuhum li dhikrillah wa ma nazala minal haq. Has not the time come to those who believe that their heart submit to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the truth that has come down to them? The moment Fudail ibn Iyad heard this ayat, he said, I will remember Allah from now onward. And then he ran away. He became a great, great scholar. Fudail ibn Iyad. So he used to stay in Makkah and Medina. Abdullah bin Mubarak used to compose the poetry for him. Ya Abid al-Haramain. There's a lot of the long poetry. So he was become very great. Because of what? Because of the guidance from the Quran. Hudan linnas. Quran is just will give us guidance. Quran, if you cannot take guidance from Quran, we have to check our heart. There's a lot of disease in our heart. Our heart still lot of thing, disease need to be cured. If we have not make effort to cure our heart, we will not able to see the greatness of Allah SWT in this Quran. We will not able to see the real life in Akhirah. We will not be able to see the greatness of this Quran. And we only will recite and read and read and read. But Alhamdulillah, recitation of Quran also will give us some benefit. But if our heart is cleansed, true cleanse, and then we will see the real, the powerful of this Quran and the greatness of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. And it's only take a little effort. It's only take a little effort. Instead of, for example, opening your books on your novel, open the Quran. What is different? You spend your time on your phone for maybe 10 minutes. So divide 5 minutes for my phone, 5 minutes for my Quran. So divide your time. Don't let your time expired without recitation of the Quran. May Allah Subhanahu wa Taala grant us the ability to make practice in our life and grant us the ability to make our life accordance in the Quran. And may Allah Subhanahu wa Taala may Allah Subhanahu wa Taala grant us the love of this Quran in this month of Ramadan. Because only this month of Ramadan we can love the Quran. Other than that, the appetite of reading the Quran is gone. It's gone. Because this is a month that we can see people are recite Quran. Other than that, you don't see the people recite Quran. So make effort in this month, bring that appetite and bring that taste, sweetness of recitation of Quran, and continues until we die. So may Allah SWT give us understanding. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.